Hey guys, welcome back to the Catnip Podcast. My name is Grace and I will be your host today, like always. Today is February. No, it's not February anymore. It is March. I'm going off of no show notes because today is a very busy day and as will be tomorrow. So I don't have quite a whole lot of time. Today is March 3rd, Friday, March 3rd. And the podcast about knitting and crafting and dyeing yarn and occasionally baking, tea, cats, happy stuff like that. So if you'd like to join me, you can go get your craft and you can go get a nice beverage if you like, and you can come back and join me for some good chat. So this week is going to be a little bit shorter just because today's a very busy day. There's a wedding that Sam and I are going to, and he's taking a half day off of work, so that's exciting, but I want to be done when he gets home. And tomorrow we have some fun plans, or we talked about doing some fun plans, and so I don't know if I'm going to have time to upload. Hi! Birdie's sitting over here watching me, taunting me like he's going to come up here and join. But I don't think he actually will. And so I just wanted to make sure that I got something out to you guys because I wanted to do that. Because I also got some new yarn. I got some yarn acquisitions and that's really fun. And so I wanted to show you guys that happened. As always, the show notes can be found on my blog. If you're on YouTube, you can click the link in the down bar and you will be directed to the show notes. I am on Twitter and Facebook and Ravelry and Instagram, but I'm most active on Instagram and Ravelry. I'm getting better at that. So my username is LittleMinky93. All of that will be linked in the show notes, so don't worry. It'll also be linked in the down bar. What is Birdie doing? It'll be linked in the down bar to all those places. I also have a yarn, hand-dyed yarn business called the Catnip Yarns. Surprise, surprise. And that is catnipyarns.bigcartel.com. That will also be linked in the show notes and down below. I'm getting better at including links everywhere because I know that sometimes it can be hard to find them sometimes if they are not there. Obviously, if they are not there, you can't find them. So I'm going to do better at that. And I apologize if anybody's had a hard time finding links to certain things in the past. It's a learning process. I'm trying to learn everything along the way. But I appreciate everybody's patience and all the kindness is greatly appreciated. So this week I only have two knitting things. I have not dyed any yarn. So I still have a pile of yarn sitting here looking at me. So I did not knit very much. I knit on two things. Actually, I did knit a lot. I knit a lot on one thing in particular. And then I cast on something literally yesterday afternoon because I wanted to, and so I did. I did not dye anything. Lots of cleaning and organizing still. So I did go to a yarn store. Yay! And I'll talk about that after I'm done talking about my whips. And then I'll also show you my yarn acquisitions. Can never say that word right on the first try. That I got at this yarn store and the plans that I have for them because I am so excited. So excited. Okay, so we can start with new projects, which is super fun because this is my yarn that I'm knitting with, and that is very exciting. And so, and Birdie, are you going to be loud and noisy? But this is going to be, let's see, I have the name of the pattern up because I was working on the pattern. This is called the Quaker Yarn Stretcher, which I know is a very, Birdie's being very needy. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Are you causing a ruckus? Are you causing...
I'm working on the Quaker Yarn Stretcher. And it is by Stitch Nerd Designs. I apologize for any sound that you hear in the background. Birdie is going crazy right now. I don't know what he's playing with. He has a bunch of toys over there, but they are distributed around the apartment, because that's what cats do. Anyway, so I am making this Quaker yarn stretcher, which a lot of people, it's very good for like crazy yarn or like a special skein that you want to use or like hand spun. It's like a, are they called boomerang? Boomerang shawls? It's kind of like half of a diamond if you cut it long ways. I think those are called boomerang. Boomerang shawls? Yes. So, you increase on one side and you decrease on the other side. An asymmetrical shawl? You guys, I think you guys know. Hopefully that will make sense. Anyway, so this is very, very little progress that I have done, obviously. Very, very little. But it is a very, very fun knit because it's also, like I said, out of my own yarn. This does not have a colorway name yet. But this is on my chic base, which is the single... The single merino. So, but it's like a bunch of blues and a little bit of green, and then we have like a flex of purple and flex of pink. So this is what I'm knitting. Very like lightweight and just kind of like flowy. I think it'll be a good shawl weight for spring and the summer for Texas, not the summer. At least it's spring. Spring in Texas, so... That is very exciting. I am looking forward to see how that knits up. And I think once it blocks out, it'll block out even more like soft and squishy and very flowy. And I'm very happy. Very, very happy, very excited. I'm going to take another drink of my tea. Drinking. So this came with the marled triangle fade shawl from Stephen West that I got for my birthday. I got a little progress on it this week, but it's not enough to like be like, oh, look what I did. I did wind up the last two colors, so that is very exciting. I am ready to go with that. But anyway, so that is living in that bag, so this doesn't technically belong with that, but that's okay. We're gonna pretend like it does. This is my old romance cardigan by Hohe Locatelli, and look at these sleeves that are wonderfully grafted together. Look at all this. Look at these sleeves. They are beautifully grafted together. You can't even see the line. Actually, I'm sure you can if you look closely, but like I am... Yeah, you can totally see it. Like, I have little messies up right there, but I am so proud of myself. I am not the world's best grafter, but I feel like this project in particular, if you do the sleeves at the end, you will be a pro grafter, because there is just so much grafting. If you've made this shawl, this sweater, you know what I'm talking about. I posted some pictures on Instagram and I think a story maybe, and then several people responded and they were like, I remember that sweater and there was so much grafting. So I'm very proud of myself for doing so well, because I really want to do well on this sweater. It's definitely one of those sweaters where it's like, I'm gonna do everything I possibly can to make this as perfect as possible, because I really want this to work out well. And it's very fulfilling when that happens, and it's just like, yes, I did this correctly, and it's going along the same with the pattern. I'm following it to a T, and there hasn't been any issues, like, reading the pattern. For a while there was, and I thought I was doing something wrong, but in actual fact, I was just fine, and I was just freaking out about it and, like, overthinking it. So yes, again, this is the Old Romance Cardigan by Hohe Locatelli, and it is a wonderful, wonderful pattern. As you can see, I am now on the body, where you can kind of see I have done the arm. Here's the armpit, right there. So I've done a fair amount of progress past that, but not a whole lot, because it is a lot of stitches, and it is a lot of stitches, and it's on very small needles and small yarn. So, but it's a very nice, like, I'm just knitting here. Birdie! Birdie is such a needy cat. Oh my goodness. Where was I? So it's a very easy knit to just kind of be like, I'm just knitting along. Long rows, I increase every certain amount of rows for so many times, and then I knit until I have like 15 inches or something like that. So it's definitely I've definitely gotten past the like the challenging part of the pattern, and now it's more of a like calm and relaxing, and I'm very excited about that. I'm looking forward to that. I so enjoyed the construction of it, and I enjoyed the lace panels once I got the hang of them, and even though like some of it was just kind of like, I don't want to do that, it was so much fun. I've really enjoyed knitting this. If you're up for a little bit of lace, you definitely have to be able to like understand sweater construction and be very like, well, you have to be very good at reading patterns and like trusting patterns. I'm not very good at that. I need to get better at that. But just gotta trust the pattern, and it will help you do great things in life. So this is the body, and we have a sleeve and another sleeve. If anyone's interested, the grafting tutorial that I used was the one on the Pearl Bee. It's very informative. The pictures are great. I believe there's a video too if you prefer videos. On the same page. So it was very good. It was very, very wonderful. So yes, this is what I've been working on. Mostly I have just now finished my first skein of the colors, which I will now tell you, and the yarn that I'm using. So this is Madeline Tosh Mo Light, which is got merino and mohair in it. So it's a little bit more fuzzy than your normal Tosh Merino Light, which is wonderful. It is, it's just new stuff all around. I'm knitting with new yarn, I'm doing new construction, getting better at new techniques. Woohoo! It's great. Anyway, so the body, the gray color, is Kitten. It's so beautiful. So beautiful. And then you can see that's where I picked up stitches for the arm to knit the body. And then white, the lace panels, where are you? There we are. The white is Antler, which is just like their cream, natural undyed. I'm sure it's not undyed, but it's their natural colorway, so it's very nice. It's knitting up very wonderfully. The only thing that I did have an issue with when I was crafting is that because the yarn has mohair in it, the fibers got like tangled super easily. So when I was like, obviously you need a long end because you're grafting an entire sleeve. So when I was like threading the long ends through to like keep on going, things would get snaggled, and that got kind of frustrating after a while, but I powered through, I did the good work, I got it done, and I am so happy with it. So, and that's all that really matters, right? Like, it's ultimately going to be a really great cardigan. I'm so excited. Again, another really great lightweight sweater for Texas in the spring and the summer. You might ask, why the summer? If you're from Texas, but if you think about being in cold, air-conditioned places, it's freezing there. So, because inside it's cold, outside it's hot. Sometimes you need sweaters in the summer because it's freezing inside. You gotta take care of that because you don't want to be cold inside. That's the thing. So, I'm going to take another drink now. So delicious. I love tea and coffee, but I'm drinking tea right now, so tea is so good. So, there was no yarn dyeing, so I'm not going to talk about that, but you can still buy my yarn if you go to canityarns.bigcartel.com. There are lots of options there if you'd like to check them out. And if you'd like to see what is in the shop, you can go back to last week's episode, and which I believe is episode 18? I think? 17, 18, something like that. Oh, we're almost at 20 episodes! What is that? So, I'm just going to move right along to my yarn adventures yesterday. I took an adventure and drove to a yarn store, which is about 20 minutes away, which is really not that bad, for Dallas, or Houston, really, but I'm in Dallas or Irving, so. Locations. And it was so much fun. I really enjoyed, like, obviously getting out of the house and just kind of, like, going and doing stuff. Like I did with a coffee shop last week. That was just so much fun. And I got some yarn. It was really great. The yarn selection was wonderful. You're probably wondering what the yarn store is called. It is called Yarn and Stitches. And it's super fun. It's in like a little strip mall and their sign just says yarn. But that pretty much gives it away. It's not like it's hard to find. It's very clearly there. And so when you walk in, you're just like, there's both the side walls are like full of yarn. And when I walked in, there was a class going on. And so that was super cool because I got to like see those people. I didn't really talk to a whole lot of people, but just because they were busy. But they do have a knit night on Tuesday, and I'm possibly going to go do that because that sounds like a lot of fun. And that will be really great. So hopefully I'm going to get that a try. But I did get 3 skeins of yarn because, yes. I got birthday yarn, and I haven't gotten yarn since. So I feel like birthday yarn doesn't count because that was a gift, right? That totally doesn't count, right? I got more yarn, and I will show it to you now. They're all Manos del Uruguay. Uruguay? Uruguay. Yeah, Uruguay. I don't know why I'm having problems pronouncing this. This is very, very normal. Okay, so this is the Alegria base, and yes, so this is the skein, and this is the Jacarandia colorway. This is the tag right there. That is the name. And then, so it is, oh, I believe that is upside down. It is superwash merino, 25% polyamide, 445 yards. It's really great. It's so squishy. I've definitely knit with Alegria, whatever. Alegria. Before. It's very squishy and it's just like. It is, I know it's probably their normal like sock yarn and stuff, but I don't know if I want to do socks with that, with this, because it's just so pretty and it's just so squishy. I think I want to do a shawl. I don't know what kind of shawl, but it is super pretty. And there's definitely more like pink and like, right there, there's more pink. more pinks and purples and blues. And it's just so pretty. It's so springy. So, yes, I got that, and I'm very excited about that. They had so many different colors, and I was just like, I don't know which one to pick. So I went with spring colors. I was like, spring, summer, like, this is good. I'm being prepared for the spring and summer. There's, like, but this can also be, like, in the winter. It can be, like, frozen colors. Right? Yeah, totally. So, that's very exciting. The other two skeins are also Manos del Uruguay, but this is on their Fino base, which is a single, and I got two different colorways. The top one is Rosewater, and the bottom one is Habesham. So this is Rosewater, and this is Habesham. And I think these are so pretty together. Like, goodness gracious, I love these two. I saw them hanging on the wall next to each other, and I was like, oh, I have to get that. So this is 30% silk, 70% extra fine merino in a single. There's 490 yards. And what I think I'm going to do is like a Marley shawl. And now that I say that, I don't think that there's going to be enough for an entire Marley shawl, but I'll figure it out. Either way, these two are going together for sure. They're definitely going to be together in a shawl because it's just so pretty, and I love the two colors together. So, yes, this is definitely nervous. It's just like I can't stop squishing them because they're just so soft. So yes, those are the three skeins of yarn that I got. There was more that I wanted to get, but obviously not a good idea to walk in and buy all the yarn that you want because budgets are a thing and I don't have space currently because I already have not even my entire stash here. So you need to find room, or I need to find room for that first, and then I can purchase more yarn, but three skeins is not gonna be an issue. That being said, they had so much that was so much fun. That very, like, it inspired me, and I really wanted to, like, make all the things, and so I can't wait to go back. It was a really, really fun yarn store. So if you're ever in the Dallas area and you need a yarn store, Yarn and Stitches, I highly recommend it. I know there are other yarn stores in the area. There's West Seven Wools or something, but that's a little bit farther away from me. I'll make it there eventually, but this one's only 20 minutes away, so that's where I'm going to go for now. You know, I think that is it. I don't think there's anything else that I have to talk about. So I'm just gonna leave it there. Thank you so much for joining me again this week. I really appreciate you giving me some of your time and just spending it with me and listening to me chat about crafty knitting things, because that's always great. Who doesn't love knitting crafty things? As always, you can find the show notes that are on the blog, and the show notes are on the blog. If you're on YouTube, you can find the link in the down bar to the blog with the show notes. I'm on all the social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Ravelry. I'm mostly active on Instagram. All of those will be linked down below and in the show notes. I have a yarn store, an online yarn store, that is catnityarns.bigcartel.com. That will be linked below and in the show notes as well. And if there's anything else that I've forgotten, that will be in the down bar and on the show notes. If you like, you can go check out the Ravelry group for the podcast and kind of the yarn, my yarn. And you can introduce yourself. I'd love to say hello and kind of learn more about you guys and my viewers. That's always super great. So
Yes. I hope you guys have had a wonderful week, a wonderful crafty week, and I hope it continues to be that. I hope you get a lot of crafting done if that is your goal, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye!
We have a very accurate mug today because I am in fact